Hi, I'm Toby Lipinski for the New England edition of the Fisherman Magazine with this week's Web Fishing Report. Got a lot to talk about this week, so I'm going to jump right into it and begin by announcing we've rolled out yet another new feature for the year at thefisherman.com. It's our public fishing reports section. These can be found under the Fishing Reports banner at the top of every page of thefisherman.com. They're open to both subscribers as well as non-scribers and viewable by the general public. You'll just need to set up a free account and then you begin posting the results of all your fishing successes this year. We'll be featuring some of these reports on our Facebook page as well as right here in our weekly videos, so be sure to post away as you get out there on the water this year. Moving along right into the reports, we're going to start down south in Connecticut. And the big news is the Connecticut Trout Opener this Saturday, April 19th. The state stocked somewhere in the range of 300,000 plus fish across the state, so be sure to get out there, give it a shot. There's plenty of fish to take advantage of. On the saltwater side of things, Captain Morgan's as well as Fisherman's Paradise both report they're finally getting some blackfish caught in the area. The season began back on April 1st, but with the cold waters, action's been a bit slow and the guys finding fish were on the somewhat small side. However, we finally got some reports of keepers being taken along the local breakwaters, especially the New Haven breakwater. These spots generally warm up a little faster as the rocks heat up throughout the day, warming the surrounding water, so it's a good shot to start on the early season. If you want a little bit of details on fishing these spots, you can check out the first installment of the Fisherman TV from last season as we fished with Captain John Frion at the Clinton Breakwater. Should give you plenty of tips to get out there and score some blackfish of your own. Moving along in River's End, an old Saybrook reports very good schoolie striper bite taking place at the DEEP dock at the mouth of the river. It's a great spot to take the kids as well to just get started targeting stripers. An easy spot to fish, there's plenty of access, great parking, good spot to fish sandworms or chunk bait on the bottom, you get into some early season stripers. Moving upriver, Connecticut Outfitters has a big striper seminar this Wednesday, April 16th. It's free and open to the public. They'll be discussing fishing foreshore. For striped bass as well as turning shad into a striper. So give them a call and check it out. Moving over into Rhode Island, Mike down at Cardinal Bait and Tackle reports that he's still hearing word of schoolie stripers being taken inside Weekapog Breachway as they're feeding on some sort of small unidentified as yet bait. I'm sure with fish being taken in Weekapog, they're also finding them at Kewaunee as well as over at Charleston. And I've gotten word here and there of some rumors of fish even being taken at the West Wall, so things are just starting to kick into gear and the warm weather that we're seeing should really get things going. The other big news in Rhode Island this past weekend was the Rhode Island Trout Opener, and everyone that we spoke to reported excellent catches all across the state. So again, this is another shot at some great fish to take advantage of early in the season. Up in Massachusetts, we've got a few things to talk about. First off, on the freshwater side of things, Red Top, Canal Bait and Tackle, and Falmouth Bait and Tackle all report some very good fishing on the trout that have been stocked. There's no closed season up there, so anytime you want, you can get out and take advantage of their, if I'm not mistaken, 500,000 plus fish being stocked across the state. And another early season fishery on the freshwater side of things is largemouth bass. Now these largemouth take advantage as well of the trout that are stocked, so it's a good time to throw the big swim baits and you're likely going to hook up with one of the biggest fish of the year. We always hear reports of fish in excess or right around 10 pounds being taken in this early time of the season, so get out there and give it a shot. On the saltwater side of things, herring are starting to fill into all the local herring runs and the striped bass should be hot on their tails any day now. We should get a little bit of warm weather and kick things right into gear. We even got some reports of tautog being taken around the Westport River, according to Westport Marine, and the Maritime Academy in the canal, according to guys from Mako's. So those are both some very good early season spots to give it a shot, get on your first tog of the year. Let's see, lastly, we're going to talk about some winter flounder reports. Monahans Marine up in Weymouth reports that they got word of a first limit catch of the season taken out of the hospital shoals. This time of the year, it's good advice to target some of the shallower mud flats as those are going to warm up a little bit faster and hopefully kick those blackbacks in the gear to bite. So there you have it. A lot to report and even more to see on our web reports as well as in print, so give them a look. I'm Toby Lipinski for the New England edition of the Fisherman Magazine, wishing you tight lines on the water.